Thank you. good morning. And every one of you is saying, oh, couldn't she play just a little longer? But here we are. And traditionally we say welcome, but let me say thank you. Thank you for giving me the privilege of coming into your home, into your kitchen, into your living room, anywhere that you happen to be enjoying this, because I am here also in your house. And our sanctuary is a little empty right now, but this is your house, and we all pray to be gathering very, very soon together so that we can. I want to say thank you to Natalia, always beautiful on the piano. Kathy Frank, if I'm looking good today, it's because Kathy Frank is doing such a good job. And if I'm sounding good, I want to thank the Wonder Twins, the Douglases, Janice and Paul, and John Douglas as well. So thank you very much. It is my pleasure. My name is Jim Guida. It is my pleasure and privilege to be here. We have some announcements to make here. Our Christmas Eve service, if you have not yet taken the time to enjoy it, or frankly, even if you have, it's online at our website, bethprez.com, and I encourage you to check it out. It's filled with the beautiful people of Bethany. If you're part of that, wonderful. If your participation in this is viewing it, that is terrific, because that is exactly why it was made. Kudos to Kathy Sapinor, who is our web guru, and put this together, and it's absolutely beautiful. We get to see so many members of our church that we have missed since last March. We hear some beautiful music. Natalia and her brother, Lily Baird and Ben Baird, Dr. Tucker, Gary Gardner. I hope I haven't left anybody out. It is an absolute a treat. Don't enjoy it too much, please, because next year we all want to be in here together with hugs and kisses and all that good stuff. We'll talk about that. This coming week, the church offices, the church building is closed. We're giving our staff a little break there. If an emergency should arise, please feel free to contact a member of your session. If you don't know who that is, give me a call and we will work it out. But let's pray for a very safe week between Christmas and New Year. The church will reopen a week from tomorrow. Zoom service following this. I believe it's going to work. Reverend Jesse, who by the way is usually here and is taking a well-deserved respite this week, he usually runs the Zoom service, and I don't know if he has the secret password for us to get in, but I absolutely hope that it is working. We're going to be looking at the next year as our conversation, as this worship continues. The link is on our website at, again, bethprez.com. If you are of a mind to complete your pledge, or even if you just want to donate to the church, this is legally the last chance you can post-date those checks for 2020. There's a donate button on the website. Also, of course, you can send in a check, and that will be taken care of as soon as we gather again. So just a reminder, this is the last week for that. Also, if you are making a pledge to the church, then you want to get that in as soon as possible, because we being budget and stewardship, who does such a terrific job, are putting those numbers together for the coming year, so we can see how well we can operate. Yeah. So get that pledge in as quickly as you can. Join me now in our opening prayer. I'm not quiet and reverent like the Reverend Jesse. I just say, God bless us. Those of us who are here, those of us who can gather together, we are a family. Bethany is a family, whether we are in Sacramento 95822 or in Scotland, or wherever in the world we might be, we are a family, we are a loving family. We say thank you to God for that great, great blessing. And now I hope you will join me as Natalia plays another beautiful piece. May the peace of Christ be with you. Thank you. As I begin the reading from Psalm 148, I pray, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord. I'm reading from Psalm 148. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise God in the high places. Praise God, all God's angels. Praise God, all God's armies in heaven. Praise God, sun and moon. Praise God, all shining stars. Praise God, highest heavens and the winters above, the waters above the sky. They will all praise the name of the Lord because God created them by his command. God has fixed them in their place for all time. This rule will never change. Praise the Lord from the earth, sea monsters and all deep waters, fire and hail, snow and clouds, wind and storm obeying his commands. Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all forests, wild animals and farm animals, reptiles and flying birds. Praise the name of the Lord, kings of the earth and every country, princes and all rulers on earth, the young and the old, male and female. Hallelujah! Well, that pretty much sums it up. Are there any questions? There's another way to say the above, a more familiar way. Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare. God come and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature and nature sing. And when we gather in our sanctuary again as a congregation, we will very likely return to our worship traditions, including this favorite. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Praise God above the heavenly host, Creator, Christ, and Holy Ghost. Scholars tell us that the psalm is not a prayer solely for the people of Israel, but for all humanity. And is there any wonder why Psalm 148 is called the Psalm of Universal Praise? But let's face it, we are closing out a year that has given us more adversity than any other in history. One could say that in the past year we don't have much to praise. A rampant pandemic, economic catastrophe to many small business owners, teachers and parents needing to adapt to a new lifestyle, and children of all ages adjusting to a life they have never had to deal with before. Illness, death, political upheaval as no one alive today in the United States has ever experienced before. And certainly, high on my list, churches unable to gather under the same roof. And as we welcome 2021 later this week, please don't say, well, it can't get any worse, because God forbid somebody rises to that challenge. So what is there to praise the Lord about? We have vaccines to this global pandemic that have been created in a matter of months. Long, arduous months, but months nonetheless, a mere blip on the time scale. We have resources unavailable to millions of people. We have easy access to power, shelter, clean water. Most of us have food in our cupboards. In a church that is 90% retired folks, we used to lament that we were on a limited income. Now, with the troubles of many business people, we can say with confidence that we are on a secure but limited income. We now take for granted our flat devices, such as the one you're watching this on. We have electronics, useful tools in our isolation that bring us the greatest library in history, entertainment beyond our wildest imagination, a wonderful Christmas Eve service on our website for all to enjoy, and yes, even me this morning. I heard that. This year, we found a permanent pastor in the Reverend Jesse Larson, who had the opportunity to preach before the congregation twice, before we went down, we shut down and went online, where a talented group of gifted amateurs have brought us a Sunday worship every single Sunday since March. In the past 10 months, we have not failed as a church to celebrate the Lord. We've also had our losses, including the friends and members this year, Bob Powell, Catherine Hill, and the Reverend Dick Wiley. In our aged community, our aged congregation, where the 60-year-olds sit at the kids' table, these losses are the way of the world, and we mourn our friends as we celebrate their lives. Our blessing is that we carry our memories of them with us as we go into 2021. While we still have to mask up for a few more months, the threat of the COVID-19 is severely diminished. Soon, we will be gathering again, and our passing of the peace will be one not with cyber blessings to each other, but genuine hugs, handshakes, and kisses. In the meantime, we praise God. As earthly emissaries of our triune God, we maintain the sea monsters and fruit trees and all forests, wild animals and farm animals, reptiles and flying birds, for future generations until such time as we are called up. As believers, we must praise the name of the Lord, for God commanded and they were created. The sun and moon, all shining stars, fire and hail, snow and clouds, wind and storm, all created by God, the creator of all. The primary mover, not created from something that God used, but from God, the great I am, not the great IKEA. All things come from God. But how do we praise the Lord? We are good, intelligent people, but are we worthy? Yes, yes, yes we are. For even as the trees praise God by providing shade, fruit, homes, and even as a metaphorical last gasp, firewood, and as the oceans provide water through an eternal cycle of evaporation and precipitation, all God's creatures praise the Lord, and so should we. Isaiah 61 tells us to delight greatly in the Lord. Why? Isaiah continues, answers that question. My soul rejoices in my God, for God has clothed me with garments of salvation and arrayed me in a robe of his righteousness. If for no other reason to praise God, know that we are loved. Paul's letter to the Romans reminds us that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of Jesus in the Christ our Lord. Paraphrasing his speech in the film Love Actually, Bethany may be a small church, but we're a great one too. We are the church of Scott Anderson, Lou Rooker, and Lori Fursage. Our congregation boasts seminary graduates, three of which are ordained Presbyterian ministers. We have been around over 100 years in Sacramento and 50 years in this location, in our community, in a beautiful building that is mortgage-free. We have an intelligent and caring pastor, a terrific office manager. We have the right side of the church where the choir usually sits, and we have the left side of the church where our sound people sit. And in between them, the pews will be filled with a wonderful congregational family. We are a church family, a fellowship that goes beyond the stated commission, a fellowship of this church that reaches out to all of us, regardless of any consideration or circumstance. Our campus is shared by three churches, a food closet, an assistance center, and various other groups. So as we enter into the new year, let us put aside the past troubles. 2021 will be a year of great triumphs as Bethany Church. We have exciting plans of programs and outreach as we get ready to gather again. And in the meanwhile, we shall continue to upgrade our online presence. We will grow in numbers. That would be swell, as we are a church who welcomes all people. But we will grow in our knowledge of our Bible and in the Word of God, Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit. We will grow in the love of Christ. John 15 reminds us of Jesus' words, "As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love." Accept that love. Live in that love. And when we do this, we can survive any turmoil. And that, my friends, is the Word of God. Amen. Thank you. you go forth into this new week, may the grace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the love of Creator God, and the power and communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all this coming week, throughout the new year, and forever after. Hallelujah. Amen. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.